27 minutes after 9 o'clock. Welcome back to Ask the Expert. Scott Watson is here from Watson's Pharmacy and Wellness Center. 613-789-6559, extension 2803 is the phone number. The email address, ottawa.morning@ctv.ca. You can also Facebook your questions. We're talking about men's health today. And I wanted to make sure we touch on the reason for Movember is prostate cancer awareness. Mm-hmm. There's a couple of tests that that men should take.
Yep.
The first is called a PSA test, which is simply a blood test, is it not?
It's simply a blood test. That's what your doctor will do. You know, basically in this 50 to 60 category, if you're just getting into that 50 range, your doctor should be, that's one test they will do. They will do the digital exam.
Right.
Which is not a big deal.
You know, just, and a lot of fellas have the fear of that thing, and it becomes more of a joking point than anything for a lot of guys. But there are men who fear this and will not get it done.
Right.
It's a digital rectal exam.
That's right.
It finds out
if, the size of the prostate
exactly.
And if there's any indication.
If there's swelling, if there's some problems there.
That's right.
It needs to be done, fellas. We've been talking about this for a long time.
Everybody out there.
You know, the motorcycle ride for dad and all the things that are drawing attention to it. That's what you need to get done. And you need to do it between, 45 and 50?
Oh, the doctors, especially the 50, as soon as you turn 50, that's going to be twigging. A little flag comes up. But 45 as well, right?
Yeah.
So I think it's a good thing. No. The PSA test goes hand in hand with that, so your doctor will...
You're looking at a guy who's going to turn 50 in a matter of weeks, so I have no fear of this. I mean,
No, it's...
Needs to be done.
It's got to be done.
Simple as that. Got a question from Alex on the phone this morning. Alex, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you very much, Kurt. How are you?
Very good, thanks. What's your question this morning?
I have a question for the pharmacist.
Sure.
Actually, I just returned home from knee replacement surgery, Oxford knee.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been home about a week now doing my exercise. I'm coming through it pretty good. And one thing I've noticed is my blood pressure has elevated about 15%. I was just wondering if probably this is the result of the trauma of the surgery.
Right. So this has happened since the surgery, Alex?
That's correct.
Okay.
Alex, are you
since you've been at home, yeah.
You're taking any anti-inflammatories, Alex?
No, I am not, no.
Okay, so certainly a stress and any kind of stress on our body can have an effect on blood pressure. So it certainly can be reduced, or it can have, that trauma can have an effect on blood pressure.
Right.
In addition, surgeries, I've seen some of the medicines they can affect are how we excrete water, the urination. So
right.
It could be a buildup of fluid that's causing this increase in blood pressure.
Right.
So in terms of blood pressure, there's many things. It can be diet, it can be how we're getting rid of water, if we're taking things like anti-inflammatories. What I would say is if this continues, you know, for a while, I think your doctor should know. And but just follow up with your doctor.
But Alex, in fact, you're doing the right thing by keeping an eye on this. And
Absolutely. Obviously
Alex has noticed this already.
Incredible. Yeah.
Yeah. So good job doing that and keep an eye on it and keep in touch with your doctor.
Absolutely.
And then point this out because it could be a number of things. What you have to do, I guess, first is find out exactly what might be causing that.
Right? That's right.
Good job, Alex. Good question. All right. We've got another email question, I do believe. Here's a question from Mark. I was told that frequent trips to the bathroom are a sign of prostate problems. Is that true, and how often is too often?
Great question. In terms of frequent urination throughout the night, there are a couple things that can do it. It's prostate enlargement, and so your doctor can check that out as well. It can also just be an irritable bladder, so that there are some medicines for that situation as well.
Mm-hmm.
Both things can be addressed by a family doctor, and there's medicines that can help with both situations.
Right.
I've also seen people just do lifestyle modifications. They try to tend to reduce the amount of liquids they consume after 6 o'clock at night, and if they had been drinking coffee or anything like that. I mean, there are some lifestyle things that can contribute to that too.
There's the also this, I noticed I've been doing that a lot myself this week because I started back on a more clean eating plan, which includes drinking water, which is not something I normally do a lot of. So I found myself going to the washroom in the middle of the night more frequently this week, but that's due to an influx of water. So
you know,
be aware of that too. This is something, though, they keep an eye on, and yeah, it's something to get checked out.
It definitely is. If you find your, you know, if you're having a little short, painful urinations, and please talk to your doctor.
Any irregularity, any change in the normal flow of things, for lack of a better word,
that's right,
is worth checking into.
Yep.
There's no question about that.
Definitely could be a sign of this little prostate problems.
Yeah, and there are medications to help out with that issue as well as the prostate issue itself. All right, we're going to take a break, but we do have one more segment. And those are a couple of good questions. Keep them coming, fellas, and you can do so at 613-789-6559, extension 2803. You can email us, ottawa.morning@cdv.ca, or Facebook us. And ladies, if you're sitting at home and you got a question about your husband's health, your son's health, whatever, feel free to give us a call. Ask that question on Ask the Expert with Scott Watson from Watson's Pharmacy and Wellness Center. We'll be back after this.